found it, Nim, but the Trade Federation is closing in fast.
Music to my ears.
In 1999, the latest addition to the Star Wars legacy reached our cinemas. Episode 1 received a very mixed reception. It was still a Star Wars movie, part of the legacy, but it just didn't seem to live up to the expectations of the fans.
Two more dropships coming in by the mountain.
Too many people expected too much. It just couldn't reach the godlike status attributed to the original trilogy. That, and it had that annoying gun in it.
Jamming their transmission.
Unfortunately, Star Wars Starfighter has little to do with gun-guns and concentrates firmly on the fantastic fighter craft that thrill and amaze all Star Wars fans. Now's your chance to get behind the controls of your own Starfighter and bring the Trade Federation to its knees.
Vary your speed using boost and brake.
Starfighter is set alongside the events of The Phantom Menace and allows you to play as three different characters whose storylines gradually come together as the game progresses. This is great in theory, but switching between characters every couple of missions means that you don't really begin to empathize with any of them. Instead, you just get the feeling that you have no control over the plot, which is less than riveting in the first place. But the chances are that you're not playing this game for the plot. Space combat is what it's all about. Once in the cockpit, you'll find the controls are very easy to get the hang of. The ships are equipped with a helpful targeting system, which makes picking out your targets as easy as joining the dark side. And a quick press of the analog stick will bring you back in line with the horizon when flying planet-based missions.
Getting rusty, Vanna.
The action takes place both in space.
Solo, Vanna.
Murder was never my business, Nolo.
And skimming over the surface of planets. And the missions include all manner of escorting, salvaging, and general shooting.
Jam all channels!
Sadly, there are only 14 missions, so you'll soon get through them. But then they all consist of repeatedly spinning around and destroying your target before moving on to the next identical ship anyway. You'll also notice that the scenery is pretty straightforward. Endless star fields or simplistic landscapes are all you get to explore in between the shooting. But this is mainly in an attempt to keep the frame rate up with so many ships exploding all over the place. And as a rule, it usually succeeds, except in the most heated of battles or in the two-player mode. This mode has to be unlocked from within the game, and then you'll discover just how slow this game can run. Not recommended. Oddly for a Star Wars game, the whole mood of the film seems to be missing, leaving the game to stand up on its own two feet. It doesn't make you feel as forgiving as you have been with other products in the line, and has to impress all on its own. But that it generally does. It's a lot of fun and is a genuinely good space combat game, albeit a bit on the short side. It just isn't Star Wars.
We've got to head to the cave!